Yes, yes, I know, I know. Come here. Hurry, come here. Hurry. Oh no, come here. Sit with me. Be good. Of course, she never wants to do what I tell her. What are you doing? Come sit over here. Sit over here with me. No? Daniel, what are you doing? Congratulations to your first year anniversary of Beggary Celine. No, come here, no. Stop being a cat. You're not a cat. You're not a cat. You're a little person. You're a little person. You're not a little cat, okay? You're gonna be a real live person one day, you'll see. Yeah. I had her a shirt, but it's like she always seems to want to remove it. Wait. Look at what you did to your shirt. Look at what you did. Show all the people what you did to your shirt. Look at this. Look at what she did. Because she didn't want to wear it. And so she thought she'd be smart and try to take it off. Here, put it on. Put it on you. That's your best shirt. Look what you did to it. All because I wasn't watching you. I put it on and I left the room. And not even in a minute, look what you did. There. Now you're going to behave? Yeah? Yeah, right. Adam! What are you doing, Adam? Okay, there has been speculation, yeah, that, oh wait, I'm not keeping track, wait, okay, I'm keeping track, every time she hears a beep, she thinks it's a baby crying, and she's going through a thing where she thinks she's a mother when she's not, so that's her baby, so now she heard the beep, and she went a little crazy because she thought the baby was crying. It was not your baby. How many times did I tell you? Your baby's fine. Your baby's okay. Should never listen to me. Okay, there's speculation that the last time I did the potato chip challenge, I ate a chip off camera. Yeah. I don't know who believes those things, but I have to prove you wrong. Okay, so lucky you, I still have potato chips. You wanna go get one? Go get me one. Should I send her? Go get me a potato chip. Hurry up. No? Come on, let's get it together. Okay, I'm back. Okay, all right, okay. Here's the potato chips. I will redo the challenge just to make sure that we keep the potato chip bag in plain sight so you know that I did not walk away and eat another, which I didn't do last time. Okay. That's kind of small, but it'll work, yeah? That's it. No more for me. Just one. Just one. I will not move that bag. Let it be in plain sight. That is where the bag will stay. Wait, let me deal with it. There. Keep an eye on it. No, you know what? I'll put it over here so it's out of the way a little bit because she likes to go that way. So there it is. I will not touch it. I promise. And you will see. I will not leave. And I will not eat another. Come sit over here. Where are you going? Sit over here. Okay, so I got fade cords, yeah? See how I got fade cords? I'll show you all my fade cord collection. I restrung my AOT sets, not all of them, just the ones that still had 275, and I hadn't gotten around to making them 550. So here's my Shinobis. I put that flame red, yellow fade cord on those because Shinobis are fire. Shinobis are fire, man. You don't even know how much fire they are. And my Shipwrecks, I put them on green and yellow fade. Isn't that awesome? Look how it looks when you sling them. Depends on which one they are. And some of them look really, really awesome. So they feel so much better too because they're 550. I have been wanting to change out my 275 to 550. And these are my sunsets. And I put them on purple pink. Little Bit, where did you go? I'll be right back. Little Bit. Little Bit. What are you doing? Sit with me over here. Where are you going? You want more toys? Is that what it is? You want more toys? I'll get them for you. Who's the spoiled little brat that has a bucket full of toys? If it's not my dog.
Okay, I'll put them right here. Got the one you want.
Okay, so where was I? This is my sunsets. I put them on purple and pink fade. Yeah. And then my aluminum titans. I put them on green and yellow. They feel so much better because they were all on 275, and I've since not been a fan of 275 anymore, only because I've become obsessed with 515. I like how it feels, I like the thickness, so yeah, I'm 550. 550 or die. And okay, so this one is I got these from a giveaway that Weston had, and these were pretty banged up. I don't know if you can even see that. I didn't do that. That's the way they were. They're like all, they've seen better days. But it kind of makes me feel proud because I'm like, wow, Weston did this. You know, these were his, and he like banged them up pretty good, actually. He banged them up pretty good. They're scratched up, they're scuffed, they got battle scars, you know. I didn't try to, is it gonna focus? I don't know. I didn't try to mess with these other than leave them how they were, you know. I mean, well, I don't think I can buff out the scratches. But I like the code of honor that they have. It's like, they've been banged up previously. They've been broken in. So I put these on a part of the fade cord that you can't tell it's faded. It's like reddish, then it gets pink, and then it starts to turn. Wait, do I lie? It's reddish and then it goes to from red to pink, but you can't really tell on this one. You can't tell that it's faded. And the last one of faded chords that I put together last night. Those were all the AO2 sets that I had. I know, right? Put them in a museum. Put it behind a glass container. You don't know, Weston touched these. Okay, these are, this is the last of the faded cord that I used on a set that was not a round square. And this is one of the skill pills, one of the original skill pills that I also got on Weston's giveaway. So he gave these away, and they're not very banged up. These ones actually are not that banged up. But I put them on this yellow and then green right here. It starts to fade to green, and I thought that was cool. And I needed to extend this cord anyway because it was too short for me, since I have adjusted my length to a longer length. Is that how you say it? So now they feel better, so I'm going to probably play them more now. And okay, so I don't know if y'all have been keeping up with the Lone Ranger, the often misunderstood Liam. I don't know if you know this guy. He used to be a member of the group. He made the halo, right? That was his conception. That was, or his idea. I don't know. I've known him forever. He's a pretty good friend of mine. I know him from Astrojack's days. And I support him in what he does. He may be obnoxious sometimes. He may be a little bit hard to get along with. You either love him or you hate him, but you can't deny his skill, and the boy has skill. So since he made Halo, he made Bello. And Bello, as controversial as it may be, is in fact beggary. It's just a very different style of beggary because it's got rings, yeah? Now, I unboxed these. I just haven't made the edit yet. I have the footage, but this is something I didn't get to do in the unboxing footage, was compare the Halo to the Bello. And obviously this is gold. These are rose gold. I got rose gold. And if you want to look at them, they are slightly different. The Halo is a little bit thicker. You can see the thickness there, that's a little bit thicker than the Bello, and it's wider. And I want to say they're the same diameter. It looks like they're the same. It might be slightly, this one might be slightly smaller. Hey, what's up, Artie? What you doing? But yeah, this is Bello right here. Now, I don't know if you saw, I have like a clip on Instagram that I put up some teaser pictures because I was carrying them with me yesterday to work, and that was my everyday carry. But I did a little clip in the car, and so let me do my review on these if you haven't already seen them. If you've only seen him play with them, he does crazy shit. But I have a quite different style from his. Come here, little. Where are you going? Sit with me over here. Sit, sit. Here's your little baby. What's up, Chris? What you doing? Okay, so first off, I have them long because this is the length that I like. Like you can compare them to my other lengths. That's my length. That's the length that I like. Okay. I strung them up. They're really easy to string up. There is a hole on the ring, yeah? On one side, that's a little bit bigger and thicker. The other hole is a little bit smaller diameter. I guess that's for 275. You want to rock a 275. But they're really easy to string up. And they ring, exactly, Michael. They don't clang. Let me see if I can make it happen. Can I make it happen when I want it to happen? Wait. It will happen. Wait, hold up. Why is it not happening? Damn it. There it is. There you go. It sounds like a dinner bell. Dinner is served, yeah? Okay, the diameter is, I can put two fingers in one of these, yeah? But that shows you how much room you have to play with. If you have thicker fingers, you know, that's probably ideal for you. It's a little bit, I'll say the diameter is a little bit wide. But, you know, you can still do stuff with it. And the interesting things that you can do with it, things you can't do with regular beggary. Where are you going? Come sit with me. Come sit with me and stop being silly. Yeah? You gonna sit with me now? You're taking this off of my couch thing. You're taking off the cover. Do you love me? Do you love me? You do? Okay, that's good. I love you too. I love you too. Okay, so yeah, they have this awesome, don't move the potato chips because then people will think I ate them. They have this awesome insignia, I don't know if you can see it, the Bello logo, and on the inside, I don't know if you can see that, but it says Halo on the inside, there, inside the ring, that's etched in. So, yeah, my first impressions, they're fun. These are really fun. They're light. If you're into a lighter set, you know, of course they're light. They're hollow. I mean, there's nothing. <It's> Oh, and another thing I wanted to compare. The question comes up that, well, I know I asked it because I wanted to know. What are you doing? Sit down. Here. This is a thumbchuck ball. This, as you can see, is the same diameter pretty much. So if you're used to this diameter, which it will get to that side, you know, occasionally, as you do your rolls, yeah? If you're used to that size, then it's not gonna feel awkward to you. If you are not used to this size, I mean, I'm talking diameter. That's when it's in this shape. But if it turns this way, you can do rolls. I generally do them in this flat position. I think they can be done this way. That would be this diameter. And if you can do it in that position, then you won't have any problems with it. Does he have any plans to make Bello with a smaller? Yeah, he does, actually. He told me about it the other day. Actually, last night. We did a radio show on my radio. Wait. No, no! What are you doing? Cut it out. She's being bad. I spoke to him last night and we were doing a podcast on my radio show. I have a radio show called KLG, Crazy Awesome Radio. And I've already mentioned it to some people in the group, but they haven't gotten back with me. They want to do like an interview or something. So Sharon, if you want to do an interview, anybody that might be on Discord and you want to be on the show, I play music, we talk about music, but we also talk about Skill Toys too. And so I've been incorporating him in some of my shows. And last night he brought that up. He was talking about how he wants to make smaller size diameter ring. He may not have said it on the show, but I talked to him pretty often. I know he did mention it to me. Okay, you're safe in your little cave now? Yeah? She's hiding. She's playing a hide and seek. Heavier rings? I don't know if he's going to change the weights of them. That's a good question. I'll need to ask him. But, so far I'm digging them. I can do my two-hand stuff with them. I like how they ring when they clack, like a bell. I like how shiny they are. And I guess you can wear them on a necklace if you want to. You can just like thread a necklace through and wear them. Or put them on, you know, a keychain easily. Yeah, they play kind of light. I think they remind me of an aluminum set, actually. So if you have like aluminum titans, they're probably about the same. Yeah, for sure. Hit me up, Sharon. Anybody, for that matter, if you want to be on my radio show, you have like Party Arty. I haven't mentioned it to you, but like anybody that has, you have a line of beggary you want to advertise, you want to talk about, you have anything. You could be like a maker of beggary, or you don't have to be a maker. You could just be a player. You could be a slinger. I mean, if you have anything interesting you want to talk about, you know, go for it. We do a show called Drunken Fest Fridays, and you don't have to be drunk. But yeah, the premise is that we're supposed to be drunk. And we just play music, talk about crazy stuff, and I don't mind including my beggary skill toy people into that other part of what I do. And it's pretty fun. I mean, if you've ever never heard of them, I have them set up on a YouTube channel called Digital Underdogs, which is my other group for music, for electronic music, that we all do our own original, unique electronic music. So my friends and I kind of do stuff on there. I mean, we do like compilation albums, we do live shows, and we have a live show coming up on December 23rd. We're gonna do a Christmas jam 2017. So yeah, if you're into electric music, electronic music, and you wanna hear some crazy stuff, then you should check that out, because it's fun. And on a channel, on the YouTube channel that we have, I update it regularly, so I post up all, you know, the videos that we've done. They're all archived on there. So, and now I'm incorporating my radio shows. I used to do them on Spreaker. I would do afternoon special on the drive home or something. I forgot what I called it, but I used to do that regularly. Like, I would drive home from work, and in that time frame, I would play music, and I would talk about, you know, things. I'm kind of a DJ on there, I guess. Yeah, I do a lot of stuff, dude. I don't have enough time in the day for a lot of things, because I juggle way too many things. Like, so many different skill toys, so many different hobbies. It's hard for me to commit to just one thing, because I handle so many other things. And I've always kind of led that life, but I've been able to survive it so far. It hasn't killed me yet. It probably will kill me eventually. I sound morbid on the Christmas festive time of year, but we all gotta go sometime, and my hobbies are probably gonna kill me. I'm just putting that out there. So yeah, these are really cool. These are, I totally recommend checking these out. He's got an Etsy shop set up. So yeah, Bello, man, Bello. It's the underestimated beggary set of the year. And it did come out just late in the year, but I expect it's gonna do really well, because I think it's a lot more understandable to beggary players or slingers than the Halo, because the Halo is kind of like more like a string toy. And if you're not used to like a string toy that's with long string and the kind of things you can do with that, then it's not going to spark your interest. But this, on the other hand, this is really cool. Anybody can get into this. that life. Feliz. And yeah, now that I started playing with it, I'm trying to notice if it dings up very much. And I'm getting a few little bitty love marks on the ring. I don't know if it's because it's rose gold, it might be a little softer. From what I understand, the color actually fades away from rose gold to a gold, which I'm cool with because I like gold. So if that happens, that's fine. Just with wear and tear, I just barely open these, so I haven't really put too much playtime into them other than stuff that I filmed for the unboxing and a little bit of clips I got in the car. I have not played them outside. I kind of don't want to because I don't want them to fall in the concrete. If I do play with them, it'll probably be like over grass or something. Just because I like them too much. They just look too pretty. You know, I really don't want to bang them up. But I might change my mind. I might just bang them up just for the hell of it, just to see how bad they get. How bad they get. I don't know. But I totally love how they ring. They ring like a bell. So yeah, go check out Bello. Because they're pretty cool. Look at that, when I want them to ring, they don't do it. But yeah, these are the different things you can do. Is like you can do a slip that requires no real skill at all. Which a slip really doesn't take skill. That's a slip right there, that's a slip. But it's kinda cool to have it spin in the ring as it spins, you know what I mean? And then from there you can transfer to another. These are some Halo tricks that I learned and I can apply them to the Bello. That's pretty cool. Those are things that you can't do with any other beglery, so. You gotta give it that. You gotta give it the respect that it is different. And it's fun. It's really fun to play around with. You see, I wanted to do like a horizontal. How did that look? Did that look good? Did that look good, little? She's freaking out right now because every time she hears a bell, she thinks it's a baby crying. So no more. No more. Okay. I won't scare you no more. So yeah. That was Bello. What's the matter? Do you like to be on camera or are you just being shy?
I think she's being shy. She's being camera shy.
So, let me see. What have I been working on? What, if any, new tricks have I been working on? Oh, I have been working on that, what do they call that? Slingshot, I guess, is what that is. Who's cutting the grass outside? Who's doing it? It sounds like an airplane. My neighbors are doing gardening right now, at this hour of all times. Yeah, so, yeah, I guess that right there is a slingshot. You gotta catch it in the same grip and you have enough space that it's being pulled, and then from there you can spin it out. It's a little tougher for me to do these types of tricks that are tension based because my length is what it is. If it were shorter, it would probably be a lot easier for me to do that, but it's a sacrifice
to do those types of tricks for me, because then I lose the ability to do the other tricks that I know how to do with longer cord. What's another thing? Bead rolls I've been trying to work on. I just did a clip on Instagram with these, actually, and I was doing this kind of number as they were spinning, see, like that. Bead rolls, I guess that's what they are. Oh, you're catching me. Do you usually not catch me when I do a video? What happens when that happens? Well, I'm glad you're here. And let me see, what's another thing I've been working on? Right there, that was the bead roll that I've been working on that for a while. I just haven't really showed it off. I gotta be more quicker. I gotta be more quick on my documentation of tricks, because I still need to do a tutorial to show off how to do it. Wait, you can see that, could you? How to, oh shoot. I have stuff here. It's always a little bit more tricky when you have obstacles in your way. No, she kind of knows better to keep away. Wait, where are you? What are you doing? What are you doing? Let me take this shirt off then. If you're not gonna be with me, then I don't trust you.
I think you're gonna like mess with your shirt.
She's kind of been afraid of anything I do. When she sees me doing stuff, she'll keep a safe distance. Not because she got hit, it's just because she don't trust me. She thinks that I might hit her. So no, I haven't hit her. But I did hit the dog outside, actually. I hit Nelly right in the square of the nose with an E-man. I think with my copper E-mans, she didn't feel it. And I felt more bad for it happening than she did for having it happen, because she was just like, psh, whatever, I'm playing with a ball. She's like throwing the ball up in the air and she catches it and stuff. But she can do that by herself. I think she gets influenced by seeing me do stuff, oddly enough. They say that the animals, you know, are smart in that way. Let me see. Shinobi fire. You can't really see how nice they look. The cord looks cool. No, don't scratch your face. Here, come here. Come sit with me up here. Come on. I won't hit you. I never do. Come on. Hurry. Hurry up. Aww. Oh, you poor little baby. Poor little baby. She gets me lazy. I think you're the reason why I'm not very active. Yeah? Because you want me to be your pillow. Your human pillow. Should I blame her for my failing health because I'm just sitting all the time? No, I won't do that. It's my own fault. It's my own fault. Well, don't be scared. Don't be scared. Yeah, I gotta devote myself to working out more. Shout out to Heine, because he's on hiatus right now and he's working out. He is making a better, healthier lifestyle for himself. And that is encouraging me to do the same, because I'm reaching an older age where it's harder for me to fight off things that happen to my body. And it probably has a lot to do with me not being my ideal weight, so I need to get more healthy and I need to incorporate a more active lifestyle, like what I used to do. I used to skate regularly, all the time, and then I stopped. But yeah, my advice to you is don't stop. Keep moving, keep going. my job requires me to sit a lot, and after 20 years of doing this, always sitting, it's starting to, well, not be the best thing for me. But, oh no! I did not eat another. Wait, why is it falling down? Wait, it's not... There. Okay, so, yeah, kids, I think I'm reaching my time. I reached my time. It is now. I'm over my time. 8:02. What are you doing? What? You cannot have any of that. That was not for you. I am not going to eat one. They are there, but not for me to eat. I already ate one. I ate one earlier and you missed it, so you have to watch that again. But I've tried to keep them in plain sight because I think last time I was accused of eating. Was it you? It was you, John. You sneaky snake. You're the one that said that. You're like, oh, I bet she ate one off camera. So this is for you. I left it here in plain sight the whole time. I never touched them other than move them because they fell down. Now they're stale. This is actually a new bag. I just got this bag, so they're not they're not stale, but good try. Anyway, I think that's all for this time. I'm going to let you go and encourage you to keep a healthy lifestyle. And if you can get fade cords, do that because they're awesome. I like mine. I don't know if they come in 275, but these are 550 fade and they're awesome. So I recommend those. I recommend Bello. They sound like bells, like a little bell. The rings ring. And they play really cool too. I mean, you can do bead or finger rolls. You can do all that stuff. Yes, Sharon, I know you have. And that's all I got. That's all I got. I don't got no more. So keep watching. Have a good Saturday. Watch the rest of the streamers. I know they will be there. We will be watching. Thank you. And good night.